My dear children, I'm not going to speak on any subject or give you a big lecture. I want to speak on fundamentals. And I would be speaking in three languages, in English, Telugu, and Hindi. Okay? First of all, as children, what should we do? First, getting up early, before 6 o'clock. Early means before 6 o'clock. Sun rises at average 6 o'clock. So one must rise before the sun rises. Simple. And secondly, we must complete our regular washroom, other activities, freshening up, brushing the teeth, combing the hair, preparing ourselves. And then the third thing we must do in life is we must do some walking, some exercise, or some yoga, or some physical activity. Games. You can go straight away to game also. So physical fitness gives you mental fitness. And if you are physically fit, mentally you will be alert. This is very important. And now, in the present century, when our habits are changing, and we are moving towards sedentary lifestyle because of TV, because of phone, people are becoming lazy, they don't get up morning. There are two girls. Some of them might be getting up, of course. Good girls are there always. Then boys, they are also lazy. Sometimes they become crazy. So you have to go to a ground, do jogging, walking, running, or playing. Any sport of your choice, whether it's football, whether it's cricket, whether it's hockey, whether it's basketball, whether it's badminton. I am now 70 age. But I play badminton every day 1 hour, morning. That's why I'm able to move around and be active. That's one of the reasons. And we are not doing it for anybody, not for our parents, not for our teachers. We are doing it for ourselves. Because a personality development starts with sports, with walking. This is the third thing you must do every day. When you come back, have your bath, and then have your breakfast, and then go to school, college, or some work, whatever you have. This is one aspect of the life. You may be surprised the Vice President of India is giving us advice on these basics. Because now we are not following basics. And our lifestyles have become sedentary. Some people, they go on watching TV till late in the night and get disturbed by the TV, all vulgar, obscene, violent, incoherent things come on television. You don't get sleep. You get late, then you don't get wake up in the morning. So this has to be taken care, and we must have a regular, regulated life. It's one thing. And secondly, our food habits. We must eat our food, Indian food. Any food. I am not prescribing you. You should eat this food, that food. Vegetarian, non-vegetarian, you can eat whatever you want. Eat both also, no problem. But you must eat proteinous food. Proteinous. Protein. You must be nowadays seeing magazines, newspapers saying that about organic food, nature food, then going back to our old pulses, cereals. You know what are the pulses and cereals, huh? Most of you knowing. But we are used to eat mostly rice, which is not good for health. Right? Rice must be eaten, but in reasonable quantity. But you must eat adequately other things also. Dal, very useful. There are cereals, they are also very useful. Milk, very useful. Ragi, jowar, bajra, all this, what do we call in Telugu, trunadhanyalu. They are very good for health. That's why they now try to market it, saying that ragi malt. Nowadays, market people are coming up with such ideas and all. And then now we are also getting used to, not all of you, some of them are used to get into pizza, burger. They are the worst foods for our climate, for our country. Other countries, Western countries, they have their own weather, they have their own habits. But our country, our forefathers, our grandparents, they lived and they have learned it from their grandparents. And then they used to eat food according to season. Season means winter, summer, what is good for winter, what is good for summer. And second was about what is good in this region. Say Andhra, what is the best food? Kerala, what is the best food? Tamil Nadu, what is the best food? Bihar, what is the best food? They lived for thousands of years because of their regular life. They have learned what is good for them. It is not written in any books. So they prescribed that food. So that's why they were healthy. Now as we are getting into other foods, junk foods, we are becoming unhealthy. This has to be understood by all. Recently, there is a study by American magazines, medical magazines. After so much research, they have come to conclusion that the present generation is getting more non-communicable diseases. Non-communicable, cancer also. Lot of diseases. But the reason is because of food habits, they said. The reason is because of sedentary lifestyle. So lifestyle, we have to go back to our roots. And second, food, we have to go back to our roots. And now the advertisement, the cinema, TV, they give advertisement saying that this food, that food, chicken. You go to restaurant, they name it chicken Manchuria. You have Himalayan here. Why do you go to Manchuria, Bulgaria, Somalia? But name, because we have a fashion for weakness, for foreign. Something foreign, very good. Indian protein, kya hai? Yanta pata chanta kai pachadi. Adhaita chala gopaga untudan. Not a correct thing. And then now they give you chicken 65. Name. Your age is not even 25. You want to eat 65 so that you become 65 only. We have so many traditional, you are all Nellore. Nellore, I don't know if you had an occasion to eat Nellore chapala pulsu. Nellore fish curry. What a wonderful item. It's not because I belong to Nellore, I am praising that curry. I eat all India food. Everywhere I go, I try to eat the local food. But very, very useful. Your chutneys, your podis, your other items, everything, there is some usefulness or other. So my advice to you all is, eat properly cooked Indian food. Some people say, sir, it is now instant food, sir, instant food. Food cannot be instant. If you eat instant food, means you will get constant disease. Take it from me. Remember this throughout your life and then you will realize one day. The Vice President has said it like this. Food cannot be instant. It has to be cooked. Now, today you all ate dosa. Dosa, you have to put that powder, rice, ground, and then some dal mix, and then ferment it for 24 hours. And then prepare it, and then you have to put it on a pan, apply little oil, and then take it. It's not constant, just you take it out and then idli, much more little vada. So it has to be properly cooked food. That is very important, and we have to make a balance. How much rice, how much cereals, how much other items. And also eating, see our food, You eat dosa, na? You eat idli. Idli, they prescribe sambar. Sambar, again, you have dal. You have strength in that. So, in each and everything which our forefathers have prescribed, there is some message. Then, with regard to the hair we maintain, now it's a fashion. Children, they do not try to comb, they leave the hair like this, or they try to cut the hair, girls. Earlier, you know, the what you call it in Telugu, jada, used to be up to the nail almost your thighs. Nowadays, fashion, small, ponytail. What do you call it? Ponytail, na? Ponytail. It's loses fashion. You see our old films or other things, how long the hair used to be. And because the hair is also falling now because you are not eating proteinous food again. And you are not applying proper hair, proper oil. See, look at Kerala. Kerala men and women, their hair normally appears to be black. The reason is oil, coconut oil. But we, oil means, no, I don't want, grandmother want to apply oil. During our student days, every week, grandmother used to apply castor oil. Not coconut, castor oil. Because that gives strength to the roots. That gives the strength to the roots. So that is also an important aspect in our life, to develop your personality. Otherwise, after some time, you lose your hair and you have to go for a, what is it called? Wig. Hair transplantation or a wig, or you have to apply dye color to make it black. And all this, it's a cycle. It is a cycle. So we must all see to it that we, of course, we have bath, nothing wrong in having. I have head bath morning, evening, both times. Throughout my life, that I have been. Still, there is some hair for me. Even at the age of 70 also. Then, the next point I want to stress is students must be disciplined. Discipline not for your teacher, not because of your principal, or not because of your other people, parents. Discipline must be self. That makes you a good personality. If you are disciplined, people think this man is coming. He's a very disciplined man. He maintains time. I have been trying in my life to maintain time. Wherever I go, and in Delhi, people and all, they say, oh, Vice President is coming. Earlier I was a minister. Minister is coming means dot time hoa hoga. It would have been proper time. I am not doing it for anybody's sake. I am doing it for myself. Discipline, time sense is very much required. Nowadays, children, younger generation, they don't bother about time sense at all. Time sense, discipline is another important aspect. Discipline makes you a very impressive personality. Physical fitness, mental alertness, and discipline, if all add together, that makes you a comprehensive, ideal personality. Then, hard work. You must work hard. You are not going to lose anything except your overweight by working hard. Children, I belong to a village. This is my village, actually. Behind, but I heard the name Chowtapalam. Next is my wife's village, Sriramapuram. I used to walk 3 kilometers a day to go to school. I was just sharing with all the children, I used to go to toilet 2 kilometers. Those days, no toilet, no Modi, no Swachh Bharat. Toilet means nearby rivulet. I really go there and relax. That was the time. Because there was no environmental problem at that time. Then I used to go to fields to see whether agriculture labor has come or. My grandfather used to tell me, go and see, count how many people are working. Because we used to have agriculture farm, good amount of land. The number of laborers used to come. And then during lunch time also he used to tell me, go again. So going 2 kilometers, coming back 2 kilometers, going 2 kilometers, coming back 2 kilometers. And also who used to climb trees. Trees. His daddy. Palm trees. I used to climb up the trees and then cut the fruit there only, kati punjalu. And he used to eat it there. If you bring it down, then you have to share it with others in sharing. Later we realized. My wife, she also belongs to my village. They're all kids. So they used to say, no, no, drop, drop. And we used to say, first enjoy, then drop. And then used to swim in the village tanks. Swimming is the best exercise out of all the exercises. Swimming. Then try to swim wherever it's possible. Otherwise, we don't have that much facilities. I do agree. But, and then, one doctor recently told me, sir, I told him, life is becoming mechanical, doctor. Where is the place? Where is the space? So he told me simple. Whatever you want, don't tell servant. Don't tell your son or daughter. Don't tell your mother. Coffee love. Bring coffee. Chai love. Bring that paper here. No. You go and fetch it for yourself. That is an exercise. I was surprised. I said, what doctor? He said, yes. Because old days, our life was used to be, there used to be some exercise. So you have to go to any place. You have to walk. You have to take bath. You have to go to bathroom. And you have to climb, you bend down, take the water from the bucket, and then put it on your head. No chance now. You have shower. Water comes to our head. Head need not bend. Then, earlier, to go to toilet also, I told you. And then, nowadays, you have commode. No exercise for the body also. Simple, simple things I'm telling you. I'm trying to tell you. And then, used to go for breakfast. Breakfast used to be on mat. You have to sit on mat. Padmasana type. Now, many of us are not able to sit. Because there is no exercise or habit. And then we used to earlier eat food also, sitting down, and there was a peta in our peta. Swapa, like a peta, chakka, some wooden small platform. So we used to sit. Nowadays, no, dining table. Then we used to go out and wash our hands. Now finger bowl has come. Finger bowl only clears our fingers, but still, because of English fashion, we are enjoying it. Then also some people use spoons also, no? Without using their hand at all. And then afterwards, what is the life? Get down, get up, and then get on to dining table. Get down, then get on to scooter or cycle or bus. Go to office, school, college. Get down and then get on to your bench. Sit down and then complete the work again. Get on to the vehicle or bus. You get down and then have food. Same thing up to evening. And evening, come back and get on to bed. So from getting down from the bed to getting up to the bed, there is no physical activity. So physical activity is very much required. Discipline is very much required. Good food habits are very much required. Neatness, freshness. Some boys nowadays have a habit of growing beard. Nothing wrong. But you must trim it. You must appear you are smart. I used to tell the political workers when I was in politics. I used to tell the political workers every day, be smart, shave your beard and all. They asked me, sir, why? I said, people come to you for some advice. And if you are growing your beard and then doing like this, and then also like this and all, the fellow who has come to seek some advice, he will think, sir himself swims to him in problems. He may be planning to go to Tirupati. So what advice he can give to me? I used to explain in simple words to the political workers those days. So you have to be always smart. Smart do not mean having a hat, coat, boot, suit. I am the Vice President of India. You might have seen me 95% in this dress one. When I became Vice President, media people in Delhi asked me, sir. I said, what? Sir, what about? I said, you are a Vice President, sir, now. I said, yes, I know I am Vice President. What did you want to ask? They say, sir, dress. I said, no change of dress, only change of address. Earlier I was in 30 Abdul Kalam Road, now I am 6 Mauran Ajad Road. Your dress is not going to add to your personality. Dress has to be neat, clean. But need not have that Western model of nothing wrong in wearing the dress. But what is your tradition? Kerala, there is a tradition. Tamil Nadu, there is a tradition. Andhra, there is a tradition. So you wear your traditional dress, normal dress. This is also adds to your personality and your image. And nobody is going to underestimate you. I will tell you, recently there was a NAM conference, NAM. Can anybody explain what is NAM, N-A-M? Difficult, history. NAM means a non-aligned movement. Certain countries came together to form a non-aligned movement without joining Russia, without joining America, that side and this side. There are 120 members, heads of the countries, president, vice president, prime minister. They attended the meeting in Baku. Baku is in Azerbaijan, erstwhile Soviet Union. So I went there, and out of 120 people, except two, myself and Iranian president, all were in suits. Iranian president was in his headgear that, you know, that Muslim Arab countries, they wear that dress. And I was in my dress. And a photo was taken, we were both are prominent in the photo, because all other fellows are looking similar. So your dress, your traditional this thing is not going to undermine your body. Then coming to language, we must study our mother tongue first. Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Assami, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, Dogri, Kashmiri, Urdu, whatever it is. The language that has come from mother's womb. What do we call Telugu? Mother tongue? Matru Bhasha. Matru Bhasha. Because in India we have a tradition of calling India as a motherland. We don't call it as a fatherland. Motherland. Mother has got importance in our country. Not that father has less importance, but mother is the symbol. So, motherland, so we must speak mother tongue. That's why I'm explaining nowadays wherever I go, mother tongue is like your eyesight. The other language is like your spectacles. Kallu matru bhasha ite, kalladdaru parai bhasha. Kallunte kalladdaru bhaga kanapadutu. Kallle devan kondi, kalladdaru reman glass pettukuna, zuban ninchi em raadu. Zuban ante telusu kada naaku. This has to be understood. Nothing wrong in studying English. But basic study has to be in your mother tongue. Because you will be able to explain better your views in mother tongue, original thoughts. When you cry as a child, what do you say? Tell me. Amma. You don't say mummy. Nowadays some people start saying mummy. Mummy. Mummy means it comes from here. Amma means it comes from here. You go to your room in the evening, just to practice what President, Vice President has said. Bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. You will be able to articulate better in your mother tongue. So take care of your language, Telugu language or whatever language you are all. English is useful, but first basic is Telugu. Hindi also we must learn. Many people, some people, particularly in the south, Tamil Nadu, they say, no, no, Hindi. For your information, I'll tell you. During my student days in Nellore, this town, we are neighbors of Tamil Nadu, so there was anti-Hindi agitation. So those days, any issue means work the school, go. So we went to school. They said, students are coming out. I asked them, what is the issue? They said, Hindi. And then everybody started saying, Hindi down, down, okay. Then we got a doubt. Are, amara gaam mein Hindi hai kaha? Mana urve Hindi ekkad undi? That doubt we got. We were all seeing at each other's face. Nobody knows where is Hindi. One boy came running and he said, "Do jagah pe hai, two places. One is post office, another is railway station." Hindi mein bhi dikhta hai na, central government ka. So then one batch went to post office, another batch went to railway station. We went and put tar on that board. Then in 1993, I went to Delhi after becoming a BJP General Secretary, National. जब दिल्ली गया मुझे तब समझ में आया हिंदी के बिना हिंदुस्तान में आगे बढ़ना संभव नहीं. Because if you go to Bihar, you speak in English, nobody knows. You go to Jharkhand, you go to Chhattisgarh, you go to Madhya Pradesh, you go to Rajasthan, you go to Himachal Pradesh, you go to Punjab, you go to Haryana. You go to Orissa, West Bengal, nobody knows. If you speak in your Telugu or if you speak in your English, the next language spoken in the country is largest is Hindi. So we must learn. And you are not going to sit in Nellore or in Gudur or in your town. You want to come up in life. Some of you may join in postal service, some of you may join railway service, some of you may join income tax service, some of you may join IAS service, some of you may join IPS service, some of you may join IFS service. So these services, you should know the language spoken by maximum number of people. And then you want to go abroad, to learn English also. But for day to day, intro matayetappudu andaram kuda matru bhashalo maata alavadu chesukovala. Mana intro, mana veedhilo, mana oorilo, mana bazaarulo English lo maada avasaram ledu. Alani English nechukokudada, tappanisariga nechukovala. Rendu bhashalu nechuko, moodu bhashalu nechuko, ninnu oddani devudu. Inka French nechukuntavo nechuko, Germany nechukuntavo nechuko. తప్పు లేదు ఏమైనా కూడా సంస్కృతం నేర్చుకుంటావు నేర్చుకో అలాగే ఇండియాలో ఉండేవాళ్ళు తెలుగు వాళ్ళు తమిళ నేర్చుకోవాలా తమిళ వాళ్ళు తెలుగు నేర్చుకోవాలా ఇద్దరు కలిసి మలయాళి నేర్చుకోవాలా మలయాళి వాళ్ళు కన్నడ నేర్చుకోవాలా యు మస్ట్ లెర్న్ యాజ్ మెనీ లాంగ్వేజెస్ పాసిబుల్ ఫస్ట్ లెర్న్ అవర్ మదర్ టంగ్ యెస్టర్డే వి సా ఎ వెరీ గుడ్ ప్లే భువన విజయం శ్రీకృష్ణ దేవరాయ హూ ఇస్ ఎ తుళు ఫ్రమ్ కర్ణాటక హీ వాజ్ ఎ ఫేవరెట్ ఆఫ్ తెలుగు was fond of Telugu language. He said, Desa Bhasharandu Telugu Lessa. That's what he said. So every language, there is some rich cultural heritage. So we must focus on that also. In addition to that, we must also develop a personality, how to speak, how to address meeting. So you may say, no, I'm not going to become a leader. You need not become a leader. Even if you want to become a teacher, how to articulate, how to say, how to communicate, that vocabulary, confidence. And for that you must also have some aim in life. What do you want? Everybody should become something in life, na? Our trustee, Ashok sir, you may not be believing, he was my roommate. You do not appear like a roommate of mine, na? Looks like younger. No, he's 60 plus. Now 60 plus.
66.
66. Only 4 years junior to me. So, with my roommate, we became a professor of psychology. Psychology. Psychology, you heard? Psychology is a subject. Manastattva Shastra. Here my right side is doctor. The minister also. So one is first how to speak. Second is how to speak in many languages. Third is how to be polite. Fourth is wherever necessary how to be aggressive. At the same time be progressive. Progressive and aggressive. And then we must also learn as many skills as possible. The other skills, then also respect elders, basic thing before I conclude. Respect elders, parents, grandparents. Many of our tradition in India is the children touch their feet of their parents and grandparents. Second, respect the teachers who taught you, who is teaching you now. And the third one is respect the nature. Nature is very important for life, for all of you. Nature means sun, moon, light, air, water, trees, land. Panchabhutalu, what we call in Telugu. Respecting the nature is very important. Love, my advice to all of you is love and live with the nature. If you love the nature, nature will love you. Otherwise, there will be tsunami, there will be bhukampa, there will be cyclone, there will be flood. All these things are happening because nature has been tampered with. Rivers. This Pennar River was flowing after a gap of 35 years or 65 years. It used to overflow during my school days. And in the years, I have not seen Pennar flowing. Whenever there is some water in the Somasala, they release the water, then you get water. Otherwise, there is drinking water. Same thing with regard to many of the Tungabhadra River, Krishna River, Kaveri River, Godavari River and all. They go sometimes flooded and go to the sea. So, love, live. Then my advice is nature, culture, together for better future. Nature, culture, together for better future. This has to be kept in mind. And then in our tradition, pasuvulu, pakshulu, vatanniti patla kuda premaga undalu. Avanni unte pakshulu udayanne kirakala raavalu vinipadutu unte manchi aavulu, manchi gedelu, manchi eddulu, manchi pasu sampada unte Gandhi garu cheppaaru pasu sampade desa sampada ani. Cattle wealth is national wealth. Because biodiversity, nature includes all this. Ma tata chinna udaharana cheppanu chinnapudu. జొన్న చేలు సజ్జ చేలు అని ఉన్నాయి. మీరు చూసి ఉంటారు చాలామంది జొన్న సజ్జ బజ్రా జువార్. సో అవి ఉన్నప్పుడు సెలవులకు పోతే పోయి అక్కడ ఒక మంచి అని ఉండేది, కాటి దెబ్బలతో కట్టింది ప్లాట్ఫామ్, హైయర్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్. దాని మీద ఎక్కి ఒక ఒడిచేరని ఒకటి తీసుకుని దాంట్లో రాయి వేసుకొని తిప్పుతూ ఉండేవాడు. పక్షుడు వస్తే ఆ కంకులు తినేసి వెళ్ళిపోకుండా ఉండదు. సో యూస్ డూ ఇట్. Then after the harvesting is over, the crop used to come home. So my grandfather used to tell, ఇదిగో కొన్ని వరి కంకులు, కొన్ని సజ్జ కంకులు, కొన్ని జొన్న కంకులు ఇవన్నీ కట్టి ఇంటి ముందు పంచర్ ఉండే అప్పుడంతా పంచలు పందిరి అనేవాడు థ్యాచ్డ్. సో వాటిని అన్నింటిని వేలాడేయమనేవాడు. ఇలా నాకు ఆశ్చర్యం వేసింది, ఎందుకు వేలాడేయమంటాడని అడిగా, ఏం పెద్ద ఆయన అప్పుడేమో పక్షులు తరం వంటి వెత్తినేస్తున్నాయని, ఇప్పుడేమో అవి తెచ్చి ఇక్కడ కట్టమంటున్నావేందని. అరే పక్షులకు అవి పరిపక్వమైనయా మెచ్యూరైనయా లేదని తెరవదు, అందుకని ఏమని తింటాయవి, నీ పంటను బాగుడతాయి, అవి కూడా సరిగ్గా తినలేవు కానీ తింటాయవి. కానీ పంట అయిపోయిన తర్వాత నీ ఇంటికి వచ్చిన తర్వాత, పంట నీ ఇంట వచ్చిన తర్వాత నీకు మంచి సంపద వచ్చినట్టు దాన్ని నీతో పాటు పశుపక్షాదులకు కూడా పెట్టడం మన పద్ధతి, అందుకని వాటిని అక్కడ ఏరాడదీరా అనేవాడు. ఇస్తే అప్పుడు అవి వచ్చే పక్షులన్నీ పిట్టలు కూరేళ్ళు పావురాళ్ళు ఇంకే ఉంటాయి కదా, కౌజులు చిలకలు అవి వచ్చి అంటుంది. దట్ ఈస్ ది లైఫ్ వాట్ గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్స్ హెస్ గివన్ టు అస్. పశువులకు కూడా ఇంత కనుమ పండుగ వస్తుంది, కనుమ పండుగ వస్తే పశువులన్నిటికీ డెకరేట్ చేస్తాం, కొమ్మలకి రంగులు పోస్తాం, వాటికి పట్టీ వేస్తాం, మంచి తినిపిస్తారు. కొన్ని దగ్గర మన సంక్రాంతి అరిసెలు తింటాం కదా, వాటికి కూడా తినిపిస్తాం మామూలుగా. అంటే మనం మనతో పాటు వాటి వల్ల మనకు సంపద వస్తుంది, కష్టపడబట్టి కదా పొలం దున్నేస్తాం. So these are the things, life skills, we children has to really, and then study. Study. These are all important things, then study. Study hard. Whenever you have a doubt, raise the questions, ask for answers, and then try to become something meaningful life. For that, as Abdul Kalam ji said, aim high. డ్రీమ్ హై అండ్ దెన్ వర్క్ హార్డ్. సింపుల్ ఎయిమింగ్ హై, డ్రీమింగ్ హై, ఒకటి కళ్ళ కానీ నేను ప్రొఫెసర్ అయిపోవాలా, నేను పాలిటీషియన్ అయిపోవాలా, నేను కూడా వయసు పెద్దగా అయిపోవాలని అయిపోవు, కష్టపడాలి. సో కష్టపడితే, ఇష్టపడి కష్టపడితే నష్టపడేది ఏమీ లేదు, ఇష్టపడి కష్టపడితే నష్టపడేది ఏమీ లేదు అనే విషయాన్ని మనం అందరం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాల్సిన అవసరం ఉంది. దెన్ ఫైనలీ యూ మస్ట్ రిమెంబర్ ద ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్, టీచర్స్ అండ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ వైర్ యూ హ్యావ్ స్టడీ, ఇట్స్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ అల్మా మ్యాటర్. I belong to Vishakhapatnam Law College, Nellore VR College. Once in a way we go to our college, see the building, meet the new students, Sometimes we have batchmates conference also, annual get together. We enjoy. That's how we attach ourselves to the institutions. So keep all these things in mind. Quickly, three questions. Anyone has got any question? I have completed what I want to say. Kisi ko kuch sawal poochna? Evarikaina edaina prashna unda? Adagochu nirmohatanga. Nissankochanga. Be bold. What is there? Nothing to feel shy. We need not force if they want to ask.
Sir, since we got 70
years of independence, but still in poverty-stricken country, why? It's a good question. Already 70 plus years are over after independence. Why still there is poverty? That is our question. Very good question, meaningful question. Because we did not focus enough on poverty alleviation. Becoming rich alone will not sufficient. People should become rich. We have to take care. That's why Gandhiji has said, Dindalji has said, Antyodaya, uplift the poorest of the poor, take care of the downtrodden, suppressed, oppressed and depressed people. Jo antima pankti mein baithe, unka uttan pahle hona chahiye. That's all. But we had a little lopsided development. Cities are developing, villages are lagging behind. And rich are becoming richer, poorer remains poor. There are two, three reasons for this. One, lack of education. Education, even today after 70 years, we are 18% of the country are illiterates. They can't read and write. That should be the top priority. Second one is, you have urban areas, every facility. Rural areas, less facility. So we have to bridge the urban and rural divide. I had the fortune of being Minister for Rural Development as well as Urban Development also. In Vajpayee government, I was Rural Development Minister. In Narendra Bhai government, I was Urban Development Minister. I saw both cities and rural. The third one is, you must take up poverty alleviation programs. But what we are doing, many of the states, they are trying to give lollipops, you know, peppermint, na? The children start crying, they say, Amma will give a good chocolate to you. So you stop crying. That is a temporary thing. You must know why she is crying, what are the reasons, how to answer that at all. So we have to take up programs where poor people, if you give some support to them, they work hard and they also try to join the national mainstream. English, there is a samitha only. Teach him how to catch a fish. Don't give him fish. Unko machli pakadna sikhaiye. Machli mat dijiye. Chapalu patadam nerpichu. Chapanu voddu. Madhyanam matagudu siste, ratri koramena kavalu adugutadu. Ante kaakunda, chapa ela patalo nerpiste, chapalu nerchukuntadu. Kani ivalla manu chustunnam kada, rajakeeya partilu pota potiniki andaru. And I don't want to say any, this is not an institution, this is an institution where no politics is allowed. Secondly, I am now in a position where I am an apolitical man, non-political man. I have retired from politics. So, but the fashion is, we'll give you TV, we'll give you refrigerator, we'll give you grinder, we'll give you this, we'll give you that. These are all now what politicians are doing. We'll give this one free, we'll give you Sankranti gift, then after Sankranti, Ugadi will come, what about that? After Ugadi, Dasara will come, what about that? After Dasara, Deepavali come. What about that? These are all not going to solve the problems of the poverty. This is what I said. You have to have poverty alleviation programs. No, a lot of programs are being taken up. So slow that. One. Secondly, population. We are having uncontrolled population. 130 crore population. If you have two children, by and large, okay. If you have eight children, one of my servants, those days, I got houses sanctioned to everybody in my village. And I came to politics and became minister. So one day I wanted to see, I took the character, I went to my native place, my wife's native place, and we started seeing those houses. Character was a lady, very dynamic character. She started asking, what is your name? Like I asked her name, they said so and so. Your name, so and so, third, so and so, fifth, so and so, sixth, so and so, seventh, so and so, eighth. Then the collector said, all the surnames are same. Are you relatives? That lady who was accompanying us, she was feeling shy and said, Ma, they're all my children. So one lady having eight children. I'm not joking, this is my servants in Sri Ram. So if you have more children, more poverty. Same thing you have to share. Same land you have to share. One. If you have few children, you will be able to take care of them better. Then again, the problem is of not giving priority to women's education, girls' education. Now the PM has come out with Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Beti Padao and all. Otherwise, women, that's how my wife also stopped at that place, those days. That was, now things are changing, we have to change, we have to educate the girls. If you educate a man, you are educating a person. If you educate a woman, you are educating a family. That's the concept now. So such things should come up. And then also protein food. Otherwise, you know, infant deaths, children also. Mothers also, we don't give them proper food after delivery, too many children. All these things are connected. If you take care of long-term development methods, if you get them water, farmers will be happy. If you get them 24 hours power supply, farmers will be happy. If you provide them good, marketing facilities, farmers will be happy. Storage facilities, farmers will be happy. Agriculture loan, farmers will be happy. These are the areas where the government should focus. Of course, they are focusing now, all governments. And then that is the way to end poverty. Focusing on education, that is the way to end illiteracy. And then facilities in the rural areas, increasing them is one way of reducing the urban-rural divide. And then focusing on the change of mindset. See, we can always think atrocities against women. Nowadays, we are seeing even rape cases, raping a child. 4 years, 10 years, 9 years. You heard that, Nirbhaya. Why? Because mindset has to change. Simply law alone is not sufficient. You need to change the law. Okay. But that alone is not sufficient. And there was a discussion on this Nirbhaya. Nirbhaya, some of you might have heard, na? One girl in Delhi was raped by five fellows. They're going to be hanged on February 1st. You must have stringent laws. So at that time, there was a discussion in the parliament. People are saying, bring a law. Law alone will not. Law has to be implemented. I said, Mr. Chairman, what is required is not a new bill. What is required is political will, administrative skill. Go for the kill of the social evil. I said it like that. That's a message. So we have to change our mindset. They are also our sisters, our mothers. We should not do anything disrespecting them. This attitude has to come. These are some of the thoughts that have come to mind.